Okay, we're back for the third 20-minute video we're going to do for the for Sunday, the 11th of July. We're just going to keep it at two videos for the day because we had several people to call back who had called us last night. And apparently they were busy or working and just couldn't answer them. But we called them. Y'all know who you are? Who was Brandon and Tasha, I think. Yeah, call y'all back, and if you hear this, just call us back, get them on. We let y'all text messages and voicemails, so. And to Brandon, if you didn't hear the whole voicemail, I think it got cut off for some reason. One of y'all's voicemail cut off in the middle of it. But we had like an old guy with a bald head, tall, skinny dude, maybe a grandfather or someone like that. Jeremy's just going to play while I talk. You've seen the videos like that. He might jump on and say something, you know, but it's up to him. Anyway, yeah, there's a tall, skinny dude with a bald head, real old. It might have been a great grandfather or a grandfather, someone that knows someone in your family. And then they had a young boy in there. I'm not sure who it was. He was standing off to the side, not saying anything. He was coming through, teenager, you know? So, and to Tasha, you know, there's people there for you. We didn't get real tuned in, you know, and the voicemail picked up. I think we lost focus, started worrying about leaving the message. But yeah, I felt them. His presence is there for you too. And to the person who wrote on the page has the comment about the person, their cousin knew someone, their boyfriend died in November '99. Please get back with us. I can't remember your name. I have it down. But we're here. We'd like to meet with you. I remember you said you wanted to come meet with us in person and talk with us. It's fine. But please get back with us. Don't change your mind. A lot of people like worry about this stuff and second guess themselves. I really wanted to speak about that. You know, they'll jump on it and then all of a sudden they'll start worrying. Like, what if I'm doing the wrong thing? What if God's angry that I'm doing this? Or, you know, what if this isn't real? What if I'm imagining? Don't second guess yourself. If you call us and you feel it's real and then there's people coming through, go through it then. You know, you're not losing anything. You know, there's no money on the line. We don't charge anybody. That should say a lot right there to you all. That says a lot. I know it does because we have no incentive to fuck with people, basically, to mess people up. Where's the incentive? You know, all our incentive is to be truthful and help people the best we can. You know, there's no money on the line. You know, there's no need. They're not worried about being paid. You know, we do it for free. So think about that. Consider that much. You know, that we're doing it for the good of y'all and service to you. We are in service to others, not service to ourselves. But please call us back, you know, Tasha and Brandon and rest of y'all. You know, you called us before, call us. You know, we'll work it out. We'll get up with you one time or another. We'll get up and talk. We're eager to help y'all. And I can tell you that your spirit friends and family, they're pretty anxious to get in touch with you, especially the one who died in 99 and the guy was murdered in the fall of 99. This guy is real anxious to come through. You know, light-skinned dude, tall, skinny, light-skinned dude. You know, but he wants to come through. He wants to answer questions. He wants to talk. He's never done it before. And he's happy he's being hurt. You know, he wants to let y'all know that he's all right, that he's happy now, and he's in a great place. And he wants to share that and other things. So don't be afraid to do it. Don't feel scared. Now, God is not going to punish you for that. We've actually had people ask about that, saying that the Bible says, you know, that it's wrong to talk to seers and people who with psychics or whatever. Consider this, though. Have you ever seen the 700 Club at 10 o'clock in the morning on ABC, Channel 8 here in Richmond? at the end of that, like, supposedly it's illegal and against God's law to pay attention to what they call seers and stuff like that. In other words, for psychics or mediums and stuff like that. But at the very end of each show, Pat Robertson and his son or whoever's co-hosting sit there and you do psychics, you know? They just put it by another name. They say, well, we have words of knowledge.
Yeah.
Psychic and intuitive.
I see a man that's in a chair.
I see a man in a wheelchair and a back brace on a certain way, and God's healing you now.
Yeah.
I mean, that's psychic stuff.
I can stop on that for a minute.
Yeah, that's important. Okay? Like, they're condemning it, you know, and out of one side of their mouth. But out the other side, we're not trying to judge them. Don't get us wrong. But we're making an observation, not a judgment. They'll say, like, these are frauds. People are doing psychic things, and God is angry with them. You know, God says in his word that you don't do that, except that they're doing it themselves at the end of every episode of 700 Club. Like, we have word of knowledge for Linda, either the back brace on, or who's had with a weird leg pain that's going on in your right knee. You're about to be healed. Jesus is there with you. Now, that's all I wanted to speak on that. See, look what they're doing. You know, they're doing psychic stuff, and they just give it a clever little name, you know, to make it look different. So don't be scared about retribution by God. There is none. You know, God doesn't get angry. Let me say that too. God is not a pissed off God. That's a lie.
Can I say something? Good. Go be good, go be good, go be good, go be good.
There you go,
go be good.
You know, you did fine, you know. That's go be good, you know, just be. Let me say on this, be good the best you know how. Do what you feel within yourself is the right thing. You know, that kind of good. Now, there's no specific rule, or there's no God on some throne sending lightning bolts down to punish sinners and stuff like that, and no furious God killing people. That's a lie.
Yeah.
That's a lie. Big lie. Right, it is all right. You know what I'm saying? Jeremy just doing his freestyle along to this here. It is all right. There's nothing to worry about. Quit worrying so much. I really want to say this. There's nothing to worry about. You know, don't spend your whole life sitting there going crazy with worry and, you know, thinking that, you know, you got to live this way or that way, and or God is going to be angry, or other people are going to condemn you, or Satan's going to come take your soul and this and that. It's just not true. You know, even if you have people out there who've done bad, you think you've done bad, to all of y'all out there who are locked up, all you out there in jails and prisons, all you out there who are strung out on heroin, strung out on flea, strung out on speed, whatever it might be, even though y'all are potheads out there who can't quit smoking their weed, you know, our alcoholic friends, you know, our friends out there hurting people and robbing them and killing them, you know, even if you're out there behaving like that, y'all are still our brothers and sisters, and we love y'all, and, you know, and we forgive y'all for your behavior. If you need forgiveness, we're here we will forgive you if you ask us to forgive. Anybody can forgive, you know, that's right. Christ said anyone can forgive, and we'll forgive you if necessary. If you need to hear it from us, we'll forgive you. We've forgiven spirits that needed to be forgiven before they crossed over. We didn't forgive this before, you know, and I will do that in all seriousness. So no, we're not joking. We do a quick time check. Keep playing.